गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो सब्जेक्ट इंट्रोडक्शन टू मेम्स, चैप्टर नंबर 3, रिव्यू ऑफ बेसिक मेम्स फैब्रिकेशन. आई एम माधुरी मुनीक, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन, शरद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग. सो लास्ट टाइम वी हैव सीन द मेनी पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम द चैप्टर नंबर 3, दैट इज द रिव्यू ऑफ basic mains fabrication. So just we are going to take one overview and then we are starting the today's session. So in this chapter we have seen deposition techniques, then one example of deposition in film, then what is mean by deposition, then why there is a deposition layer is required, then what are the types of the deposition layer, then types of films we have seen with respect to the applications. Then we have seen one example of 4-layer micro cantilever sensor. Then we have seen the detailed types of deposition process. So in that we have seen spin on films deposition, then thermal oxidation deposition process, then thermal oxidation furnace we have seen. Then what are the steps involved in a thermal deposition? Then chemical vapor deposition we have seen. In that, what is mean by homogeneous and what is mean by heterogeneous we have seen. Then CVD process we have seen. What are the steps followed in CVD process, that we have seen. Then we have seen the types of chemical vapor deposition, that is an atmospheric pressure chemical vapor deposition, low pressure CVD, plasma enhanced CVD, high density CVD. Then plasma enhanced CVD system we have seen. Then in the CVD system, that the low pressure CVD and plasma enhanced CVD examples we have seen. So what are the difference between these two also we have covered. Then we have seen the physical vapor deposition. So in that, what is sputtering and what is evaporation, that we have seen. So sputtering is nothing but this type, means heating, metal target is there. And under this plasma, whatever that the vapors comes from this side, okay, so that are accelerate towards the target. Then evaporation method of PVD we have seen. So in this, the vacuum chamber, we are going to feed that the metal source and over that the substrate that the vapors are there. And after that, electroplating we have seen. So electroplating is nothing but the coating of that the another metal layer. Then we have seen the oxidation. So what is so in that, dry oxidation, wet oxidation, then in detail how we are going to make that the oxidation. Then we have seen the thermal oxidation. So how that the after the thermal oxidation, how the layer will be formed on above and below of the original surface. Then according to the color of silicon dioxide layers, the thickness which we are going to select, that we have seen. Then oxidation furnace we have seen. Then this is nothing but up to we have covered from that the chapter. So today we are going to see introduction of etching. Okay, so etching refers to the removal of material from the vapor surface. Okay, so next point is nothing but the etching. So in oxidation process we have seen there is a wet etching and dry etching. So etching refers to the remove of material from the vapor surface. So the process is usually combined with lithography in order to select specific areas on the wafer from which material is to be removed. Okay, so the process is usually combined with lithography in order to select specific area on the vapor from which material is to be removed. So etching represents one way of permanently transferring the mask pattern from the photoresist to the vapor surface. Okay, so etching represents one way of permanently transferring the mask pattern from the photoresist to the vapor surface. So the complementary process to etching is deposition, okay, or the growth, where new material is added. Okay, so the complementary process to the etching is nothing but the deposition. So in this chapter we have seen the deposition. Deposition is nothing but the grow of that the layer on that the substrate. But etching is nothing but the reverse process, removing that the material from that the vapor surface. So unlike oxidation or nitration, where the underlying SR is consumed to form the oxide, that is nitrate layer, in deposition new material is added without consuming the underlying vapor. Okay, so unlike oxidation or nitration, where the underlying SI is consumed to form the oxide, that is nitrate layer, in deposition new material is added without consuming the underlying vapor. So etching is nothing but the removal of the material from that the vapor surface, and deposition is nothing but the growing that the surface a layer on that the substrate. Then there are two types of the etching. So wet etching and in a dry etching. The dry etching has the sub classified into following categories. One is the plasma etching, ion beam milling, and reactive ion etch. Okay, so let us see the first type, that is wet etching. So in a wet etching, the vapor are immersed in a tank. Okay, so this is nothing but the silicon vapor which is immersed in the tank, which is filled by the solution. So reactants is added. So the tank of etchant, that is mix of chemicals as shown in a figure. So there is a chemical reaction between the water surface and etchant that helps the material remove. So in between these two, that the chemical reaction will take place. So either the photoresist layer or a hard mask like oxide or nitride layer is used to protect the rest of the vapor. Okay, so in a wet etching, one solution, that is etchant, we have taken, and from which we want the unwanted material removed, that the SI vapor is placed inside that reactant. So due to the chemical reaction, that the material is removed, but either a photoresist layer or a hard mask like oxide or nitrate layer is used to protect the rest of that the paper. Because if we put it as it is into that the solution, then all the materials get etched. But we want the specific area must be etched. So remaining part of that the structure we have to protect from that the etchant. So photoresist layer or hard mask is used, that is oxide. Okay, so this oxide will play a very important role to protect this from this etchant. Then the time for etching depends on the amount and type of the material that needs to be removed. Okay, so there is no any standard that the time period is there to etch that the, or to remove that the material from that substrate or that the structure layer. It is depends upon that the amount and the type of the material that needs to be removed. So depending upon that, it will the process time will be defined. Then potassium hydroxide, that is KOH, is a common etchant used to remove the SI. Okay, so to remove that the silicon, the potassium hydroxide, that is KOH, is commonly used as the etchant. So usually 30% of KOH solution is used. So usually how many percent of the KOH solution is used? The 30% percent of KOH is used. So which has a etch rate of 100 micrometer per hour. Okay, so what is that the etch rate of that the potassium hydroxide? That is 100 micrometer per hour at 90 degrees Celsius. If the means surrounding temperature is 90 degrees Celsius, then potassium hydroxide can eat 100 micrometer per hour. So thus, an entire 4 wafer with, that is, sorry, 4 inch wafer with thickness of 500 micrometer can be etched through in approximately 5 hours. Okay, so what are the calculation? So thus, an entire 4 inch wafer, that is 4 inch wafer with thickness of 500 micrometer can be etched through in approximately 5 hours. So the etch rate of silicon 100 by 30 KOH is shown in figure 2. Okay, so let us see first upon figure 2. Okay, so this is nothing but the figure 2. So starting surface after development of the resist. Okay, so here semiconductor insulating film is there and resist mask is placed over here. So when the etching process will take place, this part is going to be removed because this part is protected from the resist mask. So figure B shows that the surface after the wet etching, means after the wet etching, here the part is of insulating material is removed. Then surface after dry etching, because of the anisotropic nature of etching, dry etching produces more vertical flat. Okay, so these are nothing but that the dry etching, and dry etching produces that the more vertical side walls compared to the wet etching. Okay, so here the wet etching is done, and in this surface dry etching is done. So curve related to that, here the sharp curve and here that the triangular curves are there. So we can conclude that wet etching is better than the dry etching is better than the wet etching, and dry etching produces more vertical side walls compared to the wet etching, but the removal rate is slower. But this process is slower than the this one, that is wet etching. So let us see that the next thing, after the etching the vapors are rinsed. So usually in dilution water for removal of etchant and then finally dry. Okay, so after etching the vapors are rinsed usually in dilution water. For removal of etchant and then finally dry. So wet etching is used for removal of material from large areas, so trench size greater than 3 micrometer. So for smaller areas where greater precision in removal of material is required. Okay, so for smaller areas where greater precision is in removal of material is required, so you know, dry etch is preferred. So then we etching a process, wet etching process is anisotropic, that is the etch rate depends on the plan of the SI wafer, so from which atoms are being removed. Okay, the wet etching process is anisotropic, that is the etch rate depends on the plane of SI wafer from which atoms are being removed. So if you compare the wet etching and dry etching, wet etching gives the fast response, but the whatever that the walls are not a perfect vertical, but in a dry etching it will give you the vertical walls, and but the process is very slow. So the next, dry etching. So dry etching, as the name suggested, is a removal of material in the absence of solvent. Okay, so the dry etching name itself says that the removal of material in the absence of the solvent. So the process was introduced because wet etching had some limitations. in its applicability, which are listed below. Okay, so the process was introduced because wet etching has the some limitations, so that's why the dry etching. So wet etching is used for large pattern sizes. Okay, so wet etching is used for the large pattern sizes, usually larger than 2 micrometers. So it is an isotropic process. Sloped slide walls rather than the straight walls. Okay, sloped side walls rather than the straight walls. So first is the wet etching is used for the large pattern which is having larger than 2 micrometer. After the wet etching, that is nothing but the isotropic process. The sloped side walls are there. Wet etch has to be combined with subsequent rinse. So wet etch has to be combined with subsequent rinse and dry state. So this increase chances of defect or contamination. Okay, so wet etch has to be combined with the subsequent rinse and dry state. So this increases chances of defects or contamination. Okay, so hazardous chemicals and conditions are used. So safety is an issue. Safe deposit of chemical is essential. So hazardous chemicals and conditions are used. So safety is an again issue. Safe deposit and chemical is essential there. Then next is the undercutting and resist peel off can happen. If time is not controlled. Okay, so undercutting and resist peel off can happen if time is not controlled, or each conditions change during process, Okay, so if the we are not operating that the wet etching time by time or timely, then there will be undercutting or resist peel will happen, and each condition change during the process also. So these are the limitations in the wet etching. So already we have seen in this figure, if this is the nothing but the starting surface after development of the resist. So here wet etching is used. So here sloped side walls are there, and in this dry etching vertical side walls are there. So but dry etching process is slower and the wet etching is the faster. So we are going to summarize this session. So we have seen the what is mean by etching, that is removal material from the water surface. Then we have seen the what are the steps, types of the etching. There is a wet etching and dry etching, and in this dry etching there are three types: plasma etch, ion beam milling, and reactive ions. So in a wet etching, whatever that the removal of the part from that the vapor, so we have to dip that vapor in reactants, and which we do not want that the etching, that said we have to place that the oxide. Okay, then the potassium hydride is nothing but the one of the best that etchant used for the silicon. So after that we have seen that the dry etching, and dry etching is nothing but the removal of the material in the absence of solvent. So why the dry etching? Because there is a limitations in the weightaging. So what are the limitations? It is usually used for the large pattern size. When isotropic process sloped side walls, it will produce means combined or subsequent winds increase chances of the defect or contamination. Then safe deposit or chemicals is essential. And if suppose the time being is large, then undercutting and resistill will occur. And after that we have seen what is the effect of that, the wet etching and dry etching. Okay, so in the today's session we have seen that the dry etching and the wet etching. Okay, thank you.